Hello and welcome to Function Excel. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use the hlookup function. If you are already familiar with the vlookup function, then this is basically the same thing. In the vlookup function, we are looking for data in a vertical way, and in the hlookup function, we are looking for data in an horizontal way. So it's the same function, but that's the only difference. So, and that's why one is called VLOOKUP for vertical, and one is called HLOOKUP for horizontal. So here I have a table of data, and I have how many people visit a park, and so every month of the year, how many people, and so if it were men, women, children, or elderly, and how many people in total. So what I want to know here, let's say we want to find out how many children visit the park in June. So let's first take a look at the arguments of our hlookup function. So hlookup, the first argument is the lookup value. The lookup value is what we are looking for here. So what we are looking for is the month name, so June. So I'll just select here cell C9, or I could also type here June like this, and it must be inside double quotes to tell Excel that it's a text string and not a number. If we don't do that, we would get an error. So, but it's easier, just select the cell like this, and if I want, I can just later change June to whatever month I want, and I will get the data from that month. The second argument is the table array. The table array is the range where the month that I'm looking for and the data that I want to get in result are, and the first column, or sorry, the first row that I select, it must be the row where the lookup value is in. So in this case, I must select first row number 2 and then the rest of the data. Of course, I could start from here, but I mean that the first row on the top, it must be the row where my lookup value is. I cannot do it like this because June is not in row 1, it's in row 2, so I must do it like this. Then the next argument is the row index num. That is, in which row is the data I want to get, so the children, how many children went to the park. So in which row that is relative to the first row that I selected. So the first row that I select was number 2. So this one is going to be row number 1. And children, they are in the 1, 2, 3, 4, in the fourth row, starting to count from here. So the row index num here is going to be 4. Then our last argument is if we want an approximated match or an exact match. So again, this is exactly how VLOOKUP works. If you're not familiar with VLOOKUP, there's a link in the description here, and you can check it out. So for this first example, we're gonna use the exact match, meaning that we want to find exactly June here. So just type false, and that's it. So we have the number 331. So if we check here, June children is 331, so we get the right number. If I change here from June to, let's say, March, I have the number 286, which is here, 286. And I could also change the number here, our row index num, let's put it number 2. So now what we are getting is the number of men who visit the park. So here in March, men, so 5998. So let's go to our next example. In this one, we're gonna use the approximated match. So here I have the price table, the ticket table to enter this park. So depending on how old the person is, the price is different. So from 0 to 15, it should pay $5. From 16 to 59, it should pay $10. And from 60 or more, it should pay $1 only. So I have here a few people and how old they are. And we want to know how much each one of them should pay to enter the park. So again, we're going to use our VLOOKUP function. So, oh, sorry, not VLOOKUP, HLOOKUP. HLOOKUP function. Our lookup value is going to be their ages. So first one is this one. Then we have the table array. The table array, again, the first row that I select, it must be the row where the lookup value is. So select this one where the ages are. And the last one is going to be the price, which is the data that I want to get in result. I'm also going to freeze this reference here. So just press F4 and the keyboard. If you want to learn more about that, link in the description. Then the next argument is our row index number. Again, this is going to be number 3 because what I want to get is the price. And the price is in the third column, starting to count from the column that I selected. So that's why this here is number 3. And the next one is if I want the approximated or exact match. In this case, I want the approximated one. So true. And that's it. Let's just copy it down. And here we have the results. Let me just put it like it was before. All right. So here we have the prices, how much each one of them should pay. But how does this work? If you look here at the first person, he's 10 years old, but 10 is not here and is not even here. So how can Excel tell that it should pay 5 and not 10 or $1? Here how it goes. So it takes number 10 and it tests. Is 10 equal to or greater than 0? Yes, it is. So we go and test the next one. Is 10 greater than or equal to 16? No, it's not. So it goes back to the previous one and return whatever is in the third row here. So that's why we get number 5. Let's check here Juliet, for example. Juliet is 68. So is 68 greater or equal to 0? Yes, it is. It is greater. Is it greater or equal to 16? Yes, it is. So we go to the next one. Is it greater or equal to 60? Yes, it is. Since there is nothing here, like I'm not even getting this area here, I'm not even selecting column F. So we just stop here and return me 1. So that's why we get here $1. Notice that the row number 4 is just something visual. I could just delete this and our formula still works normally, because the only thing that matters is the value that I'm looking for, so their ages, and the value that I want in return, price. So whatever is in the middle here, it doesn't matter. So it's just something visual. Well, that was it. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you liked, please click the like button and also subscribe to our channel. See you next time.